So this video is about the shift in the center of gravity that takes place on a ship due to loading, discharging and shifting of weights. This is video 6 in the series of ship stability. So if this is the first video you're watching for ship stability, I'll advise you to start from the first video, and I'll provide you with the links of all the videos I've made in the series of ship stability in the description section of this video. Alright, so I recommend you starting from the first video, so that because a lot of these concepts I have explained before, and I'll assume that you have seen those videos and you understand it, and that's how I've made these videos. So let's start with this topic here. Today we'll be talking about how a shift in the center of gravity of a ship takes place due to loading, discharging and shifting of a single weight, and what happens when multiple weights are either loaded, discharged or shifted at the same time, or while the cargo operations are going on. Alright, so we'll talk about that. So let's start with the first question. So the first question says that in a vessel of 7850 tons of displacement, the kg is 8.4 meter, 150 tons of cargo is loaded on the upper deck of the ship, and when the cargo is loaded on the upper deck, the kg is 10 meters. What you have to do is find the final kg. Now I always say this to you guys, that is, whenever you see a question and it's a numerical based question, if you understand the meaning of each and every word in the question and you know the formulas to calculate those concepts, then it's a pretty straightforward question. So in this question, of course, there are some terms discussed, the meaning of which may not be known to you. So let's break it down and understand the meaning of each and every word. Now, of course, 7850 tons of displacement of a vessel, that means that is the total mass or total weight of a vessel. All right, now I've talked about displacement before in my previous videos, so you please watch those videos. Displacement means the total weight of the vessel. And let's talk about 150 tons of cargo which has been loaded on the uppermost deck. So we understand all these meanings. The only thing that we don't understand is what is this kg, and we talk about kg. So let's understand the concept of kg. Alright, so before we start with the solution, I want to give you a bit of an explanation about kg. So the position of the center of the gravity of a ship, so center of gravity is denoted by COG, is indicated by its distance in meters from its height above the keel. The keel is the bottom of the ship. So if you look at this figure here and assume that this is a ship-shaped vessel, the bottom of the vessel here, yes, is the keel, and that's denoted by K. So this distance from K to the center of gravity is referred to as the kg, where K represents the keel of the ship. And of course, kg affects the stability of the ship because it's centered around the center of the gravity. So all of us have a center of gravity, all objects, humans, we all have a center of gravity, all right, because the force of gravity is always acting on us and we are being pulled down due to the center of gravity. So shift in the center of gravity often leads to instability. It also happens with humans, as humans also it happens. So if I suddenly put a huge weight on your right hand and you are trying to hold on to it, your center of gravity will shift and you will not be able to hold steady upright unless you apply an equal and opposing force on the other side, due to which you can stand upright. So that is the concept of center of gravity. So center of gravity of course shifts with the loading of weight, discharging of weight or shifting of weight, because as the weight distributes or the weight shifts and there is a distribution of weight, the center of gravity shifts accordingly. So to keep the ship upright, you have to make some adjustments. We'll talk about that later. So let's get into the question here. So this is the concept of kg. Kg represents the distance from the keel to the center of gravity. So kg of the ship represents distance from the keel to the center of gravity of the ship, and kg of the cargo represents the distance from the keel to the center of the gravity of the cargo. All right. Now in the question above, the kg of the ship is given as 8.4 meters, and that's why the kg of a ship-shaped vessel here I have marked as 8.4. The displacement, which is denoted by W, as you can see here, the displacement or final displacement is the displacement of the ship plus the weight of cargo loaded. So 7850 plus 150 tons gives you 8000 tons. That's the final displacement after the cargo has been loaded. All right. Now when loading or discharging, D is the distance in meters between the COG of the ship and COG of the weight. So what is this D? Now why we are talking about D is because later on we'll be calculating something called GG1 that you see here, GG1. What is this GG1? GG1 is a shift in the center of the gravity of the ship. So we'll talk about that. But before that, and we'll be using a formula of W by D divided by a big W. So the small w here is the weight shifted, loaded or discharged when we are talking about single weights. And this W here is the displacement, right? So only thing you don't know is what is this D. So that's why I thought I'll explain to you, when loading, discharging, D is the distance in meters between the center of gravity of the ship and the center of gravity of the weight. So as the weight is loaded or discharged, D becomes a distance between the COG of the ship and COG of the weight. So in this case, as soon as the cargo is loaded on the upper deck, now when we say upper deck, that means in the upper part of the ship. Whenever the cargo is loaded on the upper deck, you can see here that because the kg of the ship was 8.4 meters and given to you is that kg of the cargo is 10 meters, right? This is denoted here, 10 meters of kg of the cargo. So basically, the distance between the COG of the ship and COG of the weight becomes this blue line here, which is equal to D, denoted by D, or distance, equals to 10 meters minus 8.4 meters. So kg of the ship, kg of the cargo minus kg of the ship, which is equal to 1.6 meters. All right. Now, when the cargo is loaded, the center of gravity will always shift in the direction of the cargo loaded. So in this case, it will shift upwards by a distance of GG1. So GG1 denotes that distance by which the center of gravity will shift when the cargo is loaded or discharged or shifted. But in this case, when the cargo is loaded, center of gravity of the ship always shifts towards the direction of the cargo loaded. It happens with us as humans as well, right? Like I said before, if I put a heavy weight on your hand and I tell you, and it's hanging on your hand, of course your center of gravity will shift towards it. You will be listed towards it, your center of gravity shifts towards it. So that's the same concept. So GG1, or the shift in the center of gravity of the ship, is calculated by the weight loaded or weight discharged or multiplied by the distance between the COG of the ship and COG of the cargo, divided by the displacement or final displacement. So in this case, of course, the cargo loaded was 150 tons. Distance becomes 1.6 meters between the COG of the ship and COG of the cargo. And the final displacement was 8,000 tons, sorry. So therefore, your GG1 is 0.03 meters. I have told you before, GG1 is a shift in the center of the gravity of the ship. Since the cargo was loaded above the COG of the ship, GG1 will be upwards, as you can see in the figure here. Therefore, original kg of the ship was 8.4. Now this is the kg of the ship. GG1 is the distance that the center of gravity moved due to loading of the cargo. And because it moved upwards, distance from the keel, this is the distance from the keel of from K to the new center of gravity due to loading of cargo will be become more, because the center of gravity is shifting upwards. As it going further away from the keel, the kg will increase, as you can see in the figure. Kg1 is more than kg. So therefore, you will add the GG1 to the kg and your new kg becomes 8.43 meters. This is example 1. I will take up a few more examples to show you different scenarios of how the center of gravity moves when it is loaded cargo, a single weight is loaded or discharged or shifted, and also when multiple weights are loaded, discharged and shifted. So there will be about 4 examples in today's video. So if you think the video is getting too long, just pause it, watch it later on. All right, and if it is holding your attention, then keep watching the video so you can get to see different kind of examples regarding weight distribution. So second question, the second question says that the ship has a displacement of 12,300 tons, the kg of the ship is 10 meters, 300 tons of cargo was discharged. In this case, the cargo was discharged, so it was not loaded, it was discharged from the lower hold. So in this case, it was not upper deck, it was lower hold, and the kg of the cargo discharge was 2 meters. You have to find the final kg. So basically the question is as similar to the previous question, except the different components here are, in this case, cargo was discharged, and also that the cargo was discharged from the lower deck, and that's it. So how do we find it out? Pretty much the same thing. So you find out first your final displacement. So your first, your initial displacement was 12,300 tons, that was the big W. Your cargo discharge was 300 tons, so small W. So of course your final displacement becomes 12,300 minus 300, because the cargo was discharged, it's no longer on the ship. So the final displacement of the ship becomes 12,000 tons. So of course again the small W, like I said, is 300, and the distance is 8 meters. Why is the distance 8 meters? Let's see in the figure below. So what is this D? I told you D is the distance between the center of gravity of the ship and the center of gravity of the weight. So in this case, the kg of the ship is 10 meters given to us. So this distance becomes 10 meters, and kg of the cargo was 2 meters. Right? That's given to us. So you can see that the distance between here, this distance, this is D, between the center of gravity of the ship and center of the gravity of the cargo becomes 10 minus 2, which is equal to 8 meters. So since cargo was discharged in this case, and it was discharged from below the COG of the ship, as you can see in the figure, GG1 will shift upwards. Now why does GG1 shift upwards? Because when a cargo is discharged, the center of gravity moves in the direction opposite to from where the cargo was discharged. So see the difference here. When the cargo is loaded, the center of gravity shifts towards the direction in which the cargo is loaded. But when a cargo is discharged, the center of gravity moves in a direction opposite to where the cargo was discharged from. So then, since this cargo here, which was in the lower deck, was discharged, when it is discharged, the center of gravity moves in a direction opposite from it, not towards it. If it was towards it, it would be going downwards towards the lower deck. But because it was discharged from the lower deck, the center of gravity moves opposite from the lower deck, it goes upwards. So again, in this case, although the cargo was discharged, because since the cargo was discharged from the lower hold and the center of gravity shifted in the opposite direction, again, the GG1 will be upwards. So KG is lesser than KG1. So since GG1 will be upwards, let's apply the GG1. By adding to the original kg. So the original kg is 10 meters given to you in the question. GG1, or the shift in the center of gravity of the ship, is calculated by weight loaded or discharged multiplied by the distance between the kg of the ship and kg of the cargo divided by the final displacement. You know the values already. The GG1 is 0.2 meters. Like I said before, since kg1 is more than kg, you will add it, and your final kg becomes 10.2 meters in this case. All right, let's go to the third question now. And this is the final question for a single weight question. The next question and the last question will be a question regarding multiple weights. So let's take up this question here. This question says that a vessel of 11,000 tons displacement has kg of 6.3 meters. Now you know the meaning of these terms. You are familiar with it, so we are very clear. The next line says a jumbo derrick is used. A derrick is like a, I'm sure you know, it's like a crane. Basically, it's an olden day crane. These days, on modern day ships, you hardly find derricks. But derricks in the olden days were like cranes. They were used for loading, discharging, shifting weights. They are located on the ships. So a jumbo derrick is used to shift a weight of 250 tons from the lower hold of a ship. So always remember, you have to be very aware of where the cargo is loaded or being discharged or shifted from. Because like I told you before, if it's being loaded, the center of gravity shifts towards the weight. If it's being discharged, it shifts away from the weight, and also with shifting, it always shifts towards the direction of the weight. So it was being shifted from the lower hold, so it was picked up from the lower hold and to be placed on the upper deck. So from a lower part of the ship, it was being placed on the upper part of the ship. The head of the derrick is 19.5 meters above the keel. You have to find the kg of the ship in two cases. The first case is when the weight is hanging by the derrick, and second is when the second case is when the weight is when the shifting is over. So when the weight has been shifted, so what is the kg of the ship? So of course, because there are two parts to this question, you have to find the solution also in two parts. So the stage one will address part A. So when the weight is hanging by the derrick, what happens to the kg of the ship? So you have to remember, as soon as the weight is lifted off the tank top, the center of gravity of the weight shifts from the lower hold to the derrick head. Now many a times when you go for your oral examinations, the surveyor might ask you a question like this. So what happens to the center of gravity of the weight of the cargo when it is being shifted by a derrick or a crane? So always remember, the center of the gravity of the cargo will shift right to the derrick head when the derrick head is holding the cargo. Alright, so if you see in the figure here, the kg of the ship here, this is kg of the ship here, right? This is the kg of the ship. Kg of the cargo here, so the cargo is being shifted from the lower hold. So the blue line here denotes the shifting. So it being shifted from the lower hold. So when we say lower hold, that means it's somewhere in the lower part of the ship. So kg of the cargo initially was 3 meters when it was in the lower deck. But now the cargo is hanging by the derrick. So this is the derrick. Okay, it's not a very great drawing, but just bear with me. I always tell him in my videos, I'm not very good in drawing. So as long as you understand the concept, my job is done. So the weight is here hanging by the derrick. And because the derrick's head is 19.5 meters above the keel, right? So the total distance from the derrick head to the keel becomes 19.5 meters. So hence, the shifting, which is the blue line here, the shifting or the distance between the distance between which the cargo moved from it, since it's being shifted, the cargo moved from the lower deck to the head of the derrick, the distance of the movement becomes 19.5 meters minus 3 meters, which is 16.5 meters, because this is a case of shifting. When it is shifting, the final displacement of the ship is not changing. So the displacement of the ship remains the same because the cargo is still on board. So it's 11,000 tons, and therefore distance that you have to calculate is the distance of the movement of the cargo. Alright, so D becomes the distance between the movement of the cargo. In this case, the cargo was moved 16.5 meters. The cargo weight moved was 250 tons. And because that cargo is still on board, the displacement doesn't change. It remains the same. So 250 by 16.5 gives you 0.375. So initially, the shift in the center of gravity of the ship is upwards because the cargo was shifted upwards. So from a lower hold, the cargo was shifted to the upper deck. And since the head of the derrick is 19.5 meters above the keel, the shift in the center of gravity will be towards the cargo. And in this case, it will be going upwards in the direction of the cargo. So therefore, GG1 will be shifting upwards. So original kg of the ship was 6.3 meters. The GG1 was 0.375 as calculated. You will add it. So the new kg becomes 6.675. So the final kg of the ship at the end of stage 1, when the cargo is hanging off the derrick head, is 6.675. So this has become your new kg now. In stage 2, when the shifting is over, so as soon as the weight is placed on the upper deck, the center of gravity of the weight shifts from the derrick head to the upper deck, of course. Alright, so imagine the derrick head has now placed it on the upper deck. Alright, and the upper deck kg of the cargo was 8.5 meters, but the shifting has taken place from 19.5, from top of the derrick head to the upper deck. So this is the shifting of the distance. So what is this distance? This distance is total distance, which was 19.5 meters minus the new kg of the ship, which is 8.5 meters. Right? So this distance, this is the new distance that I have to find out. So that is what I have denoted with the blue line here. You can see here, this is it. 19.5 minus 8.5 is 11 meters. So the D was calculated by the distance from which it shifted. So from the derrick head to the upper deck. Derrick head was 19.5 meters above and the new position is 8.5 meters above keel. So therefore the distance of shifting is 19.5 minus 8.5, which is 11 meters. So when it's shifting of the cargo, D tells you the distance of the shifting. And because now the cargo moved from upper deck, from the head of the derrick down to the upper deck. So from a top position, it moved downwards. The GG1 will now shift downwards. All right. So let's say this is your, so let's say this was your kg of 6.675, the new kg, remember that, all right? This is the new kg, 6.675, the one we calculated in the previous part. And now G1 will shift downwards. So your kg will reduce. So therefore, GG1 is calculated by shift of the cargo, 250, multiplied by 11, which is the distance of the shifting. The displacement again remains the same because no cargo has been loaded or discharged. So GG1 is calculated as 0.250 meters. And like I said, once the cargo was shifted from a head of the derrick to the upper deck, which is a downward shift, of course, in relatively. So you will subtract the new GG1 from the final kg that you calculated before. And the answer you get is 6.425. All right. So these were three different examples I took. I intentionally took an example of loading, discharging and shifting. I took different examples in terms of upper deck and lower hold and what happens when the cargo is hanging off the derrick. And these were all with single weights. To end the lesson today, I must teach you about considering several weights as well, because when you are on the ship, the shifting, loading and discharging is not about single weights. It's about multiple weights. It happens simultaneously. It happens very fast. Of course, you guys have your loadicators, you have your computers to calculate everything these days, but you must also know how to calculate it manually in case your, God forbid, your loadicator fails. So let's consider the case of several weights, which is normally the case on the ship. So the question here says the ship's displacement is 10,000 tons and the kg of the ship is 7.75 meters. The following operations took place at the same time. Or we are assuming it's at the same time. So 1000 tons of cargo was discharged from number 2 lower hold. Kg is 4 meters. Now when we say lower hold, just assume that, of course, just see the cargo's kg respect to your kg of the ship. And that will tell you that, okay, it's being shifted from a place which is lower to the center of gravity of the ship. So, so the position from which it's being loaded and discharged makes a difference, or shifted as well. And the amount of cargo, and whether it's discharged or loaded, also makes a difference. Then 2000 tons of cargo was again discharged from the upper deck this time. Kg is 9.8 meters. So you can see the kg of the cargo is more than the kg of the ship. So it's upper, from the upper deck. So there, just always consider how the shift in the center of gravity will be taking place because of these operations. But because these are multiple cargoes now, you have to do it at the same time. Then 500 tons of fresh water was loaded into the peak tank. When we say taken into peak tanks, so loaded into the peak tanks, kg is 6.5 meters. And 500 tons of fuel oil was loaded into number 4 double bottom tank, kg 0.5 meters. And 500 tons of cargo was shifted, not loaded or discharged, but shifted, remember that, from number 2 twin deck, TD stands for twin deck, to number 2 lower hold through a vertical distance of 8 meters. So because they are giving you all these values, it gets a bit easier for you. You have to find the final kg of the ship, which is the resultant kg of the ship after all the loading, discharging and shifting has taken place. Now, one thing I have to tell you before I finish the lesson today is that the position of the center of gravity is of course denoted from the keel of the ship, because of which it's called kg, but it's also denoted from the aft perpendicular of the ship, it's called ag, and also from the midships, which is called hg. Now today we are not discussing those questions. We'll be discussing them in the future when we start talking about hydrostatic tables, and you don't know maybe what hydrostatic tables are, so that's why I have not talked to you about that. We'll talk about how the center of gravity is referred to from the aft perpendicular and the center of the ship later on when we discuss other numericals, all right? But this is just for knowledge sake. Anyhow, let's start with the solution here. And the solution, you just summarize all that is given to you. So the remarks column will tell you what is all this happening, from which position. Then the weights will tell you whether the cargo is being loaded or discharged or shifted rather, and the kg of the cargoes and the ship is given in one column, and then I'll tell you what happens next. So let's start with the ship. The ship has a 10,000 tons of displacement and kg is 7.75. A cargo was discharged from number 2 lower hold, 1000 tons, kg was 4 meters. A cargo was discharged again from upper deck, 2000 tons, kg was 9.8. The freshwater tank was freshwater peak tank loaded the 500 tons of freshwater, kg was 6.5, and fuel oil of 500 tons was also loaded, and the kg was 0.5 meters. Right, I have not taken the shifting here yet. So shifting will be considered later on. Right now we are only talking about loading and discharging. Why? Because loading and discharging changes the final displacement of the ship. The shifting doesn't change the final displacement. All right. So the total cargo loaded, or including the weight of the ship, the total displacement becomes 11,000 tons. So 10,000 plus 500 plus 500 is 11,000. This is the resultant. But cargo was also discharged. So 1,000 plus 2,000, 3,000 tons was discharged. So 3000 tons, if it was discharged, it will be taken off the final displacement. So final displacement of the ship becomes 11,000 minus 3000, which is 8000 tons. All right. Now we have to find the moment by the keel. Moment by the keel means that if the weight is being loaded and discharged and it's all happening simultaneously, what is the resultant moment of the due to which the cargo is being loaded and discharged. Alright, so how do we do that? We just multiply the weight by the kg. So we multiply the weight by the kg in all the cases. But you apply it according to whether it was loaded or discharged. So multiplying 10,000 by 7.75, case 1 here, gives you 77,500. Number 2 lower hold, it was discharged, so 1000 tons by 4, that is kg is 4000 tons. But it was discharged, so I will put the moment under discharged. Then 2000 tons was discharged again from the upper deck. 9.8 was the kg, so I will put 19,600 under discharged. So freshwater and fuel oil, again they were loaded, 4 and 5, this was your kg. So of course you will put here because they were loaded. Add these components together, you get your component of 81,000 tons, which was due to the loading or the weight of the ship. And then of course you add the discharged components, which gives you 23,600. This 23,600, bring it down because it was discharged. So the final moment of the ship or by the keel will be 81,000 minus 23,600, which is 57,400. But because we have not yet considered the shifting of the weight, the shifting of the weight is 500 tons shifted by 8 meters, right? So 500 tons was shifted by 8 meters, and because it was shifted down, so GG1 must have moved down, so you will subtract it because it is same like a discharged when it goes down, right? So you will subtract 5000. This is 500 by 8. 500 by 8 is 4000 meters. 4000, and that's why your resultant moment by the keel becomes 57,400 minus 4000, which is equal to 53,400. to find the final kg when it is multiple weights, just take the final moment and divide it by the final displacement. The final moment is all equal. It's like that W by D that we were calculating before, but this is for multiple weights. So here 53 by 400 is your final moment. 8000 was your final displacement. Your final kg becomes 6.675 meters. All right. So when it's multiple weights, you consider them together and you find the moment by the keel, depending on whether it's being loaded or discharged, and if it's being shifted, see in which direction the GG1 is going. If it's going upwards, you will add it. If it's going downwards, you will subtract it, and then it becomes straightforward. So the careful thing that you have to do here, and although it's much simpler, it's very easy with multiple weights. Just have to make sure that you put the values in the right column and you apply the corrections correctly. All right, so this was a bit of a long video. If you guys got bored, just pause it, watch it again when you have time, when you can hold your concentration. But I always try to take different examples so that your understanding as a student is holistic. You understand everything from a holistic point of view. All right, so if there are any questions, if there are any doubts, if something was not very clear to you, or if I didn't do a good job in the video today, please let me know with your comments. If you are happy with this video, if you like watching my videos, please subscribe to these videos so that you get notifications about when I put up these new videos. All right, so I try to put up videos on a daily basis. I have missed out on the last 3-4 days due to Easter, and thank you everybody for watching. I know that some of my videos have not had good audio. I'm working on that issue as well. So hopefully in the future there will be no more issues with audio. Thanks guys, see you soon with my next